It's Miley crying in the background.
Yes.
Oh man.
Finally got chat up. Oh man, this is messed up.
Oh gosh. That was courtesy of The Takeover. He wanted that to be his play-in song, so I'm glad that we could accommodate him. This is the Insiders TV NBA show on Tuesday, November 19th or 18th? Which is it?
19.
That is what I thought.
Look at my watch.
So we have the 19th, and it is, it's going to be a fun show. Tuesdays are going to be a fun show, and I'm glad that we have these two stud of players on. We have Naapstermaan, and if his video goes out during the show,
it will.
Just know that he is with us in spirit. Someone said, Dink said to tell you to get the hamster to run faster.
I can't even load the page, man. This is brutal.
And then we have The Takeover, who is a guy that is, we haven't really seen his face around much. And so he is like just lounging around. He's going to help us. He's going to help us do some lineups. So we'll see. We'll see if we can get you on more this season. Peter Fisherman is his name, if you want to know his real name, but we're just going to call him The Takeover. So TTO, how does it feel to be on the Insiders TV NBA show?
I think it feels great. I love talking sports with friends. I could do this every day if you want. Maybe I'll do it 24 hours a day. Just bring people on to talk with me.
I need
new friends.
I don't know if we can handle the sexiness that you're bringing with that lean you got going on.
I'm trying to hide that I love you balloon that's behind me.
don't duck your head so we can see it, please.
I don't know
which way to go. Oh, that is precious. And it looks like you've got a stuffed animal behind you as well.
I got everything. I'm a mess.
Oh, and then on the other side we've got Naapstermaan. Nap, you're just rocking the collectibles in the background. You actually that's your like real job, other than winning lots of tournaments, is you work at a sports collectible shop. Do you just bring stuff in for free, or do you actually pay for them, or what?
No, it's not my shop. I just help out this other, it's a family business, and I'm just one of the part-timers. I don't buy any of that merchandise for them. They all get it, and I just sell it for them.
You want an autographed Takeover basketball?
Hell yeah. Put in our $20 bucket.
Or an autographed Takeover I Love You balloon?
I mean, I think we're getting a little too far with the Takeover balloon, but I'll take a basketball if you don't mind. So there's five games today, so it's not too bad. It's not bad at all.
Yeah.
It's better than a lot of other Tuesdays. Do you guys play any on Tuesdays, like, or on Thursdays? Do you play any day there's games, or do you have your limits? Nap, I'll start with you.
I play every day. You got to. you take a day off. The next day you come back, you're like, you feel naked. You're like, what happened?
you feel rusty. And yeah. What about you, TTO?
Yeah, I play every day. I'm a degenerate, so I got to get something going.
But your main sites are the DraftKings and Draft Day. There's actually another Takeover on FanDuel, correct?
Yeah. I think he changed his name to McJester now, though, from what I heard from DB.
Oh, that's McJester?
Yeah.
I did not know that.
He comes up to me at the Star Street pre party at the hotel. He's like, "Hey, I'm Takeover." I'm like, "No, you're not." I was like, "Yeah, he was McJester."
Oh, that would explain it. We'll see. he's been doing pretty well. Was he at the FanDuel qualifier? I want to say he was.
For
maybe that's
baseball.
Yeah. I don't know.
I wasn't there. I don't think so.
I wish you were there, though. So we have yesterday was a pretty big day with the 20 seat satellite. We had some well known names. STL won a Draft Street. Blue Stem won two Draft Street seats. Took two of the three away from STL. And then we had DP, or The Late Show, who won a FanDuel qualifier seat. CB in the house, he won a qualifier seat. And then today, FanDuel announces a $100,000 college football tournament, which is pretty cool.
Wow.
But you guys don't play college football, really, do you?
I don't touch it. I don't touch it in any college.
I played it when there's nothing else going on, but now that there's basketball, I try to stay away.
Yeah, and we have so that's a pretty big tournament, $100,000 college football tournament. It's pretty major. I know that our own Natural Slugger is going to be loving that. He'll probably he likes writing about stuff more than he does playing. I think he gets a little bit panicked when he starts playing, especially for large amounts of money. Did you guys ever have that when you first, like, tell us about your first high-stakes game that you posted. Nap, I'll start with you. Do you remember, like, the first 535 that you played in?
Yeah, I think it was probably the luxury box on FanDuel for NFL. I took, that was my first, like, shot take. And then, I hit first, I think, week one NFL 2011. I won that, and that just... You know, that really helped my bankroll for sure.
What about you, Takeover?
I don't remember the first time I played a 530. I mean,
it's like years ago.
The first time they ever started them, I was into it right away. I mean, I think I was playing basketball, so I wasn't really too worried about who I was facing or anything like that.
So basically, you were you just immediately went into high stakes mode as soon as it started.
Yeah, well, I started playing before everything. I was playing the $100 to win 180 on Snapdraft. So to me, that was ridiculous money at that time.
Yeah, I remember the first 109 I entered on FanDuel, and I had the page open like the whole day. It was just something that I could not wrap my mind around, and I actually lost. I actually lost it, and it made me want to win it back even more. And I think.
Would you play Ruds or Omzi back then?
Yes. Omzi and Rudzia, those guys were the biggest bullies ever.
Yeah.
Did they ever bully you, Nap?
I don't think I ever talked to them, but they were just fun to watch, and they had a lot of enemies.
Yes, that's putting it nicely. I think that one of them, or maybe both of them, came back under different names, so who knows who they are now. Mm. They could be listening to this show right now.
It's probably DP.
It is. It would not surprise me at all if it was DP at all. Let's talk about, though, the games today. There's five games. Nap, I know you're going to appreciate this. I said it on the show yesterday. Dwight Howard tonight in Houston. It's bobblehead night.
Oh.
So you know what that means.
It means he's going to bust. Man,
yes,
I don't like that guy.
Sorry. Do you ever take into account the Takeover with birthdays, playing in their home state, bobblehead nights? Do you ever take into account that stuff?
Oh, all the time. Tonight, Brandon Jennings against J.R. Smith. I mean, he's just gonna look to go for about 40 points against them. So you gotta look for things like that. These guys have that kind of attitude where they want to play against they look for anything. You know, they want to play against guys that say stuff to them. Just what you got to look for.
So you're high on Brandon Jennings tonight.
I mean, just for the fact that I think he's going to be looking to score on J.R. Smith, but the same thing could be said about J.R. Smith. He's going to be looking to have a big game, but he's probably not going to be starting, so you know they might not be on the court together that much.
Yeah. I'm on the opposite side. I like J.R. Smith tonight. I think that he's a good option, especially on a site like FanDuel. Your thoughts, Nap, on rostering a guy like J.R. Smith? I mean, his little brother just got demoted. He's going to be out for blood tonight.
I mean, he's like pretty much the ultimate boomer bust. Like, he'll go 1 for 20 or 19 for 20. I took him the other day for, you know, 5.5K. I think he put up like 10 points on FanDuel. It's such a risky dude. But on a short night, I think you have to have some exposure to him.
Yeah, he's a high volume guy, and on efficiency sites like DraftStreet, it's going to be tough to play him. But last night, I have to give props to Davis Maddock. He predicted 35-8 for Monte and said he wasn't afraid to play him on a site like DraftStreet, and I ended up playing him on DraftStreet. He did pretty well. He didn't get 35-8, but he wasn't the highest scoring player last night. But he did have a good game, and so if they're set up for good games, I don't mind it. But J.R. Smith, he absolutely scares me to death. Raymond Felton, though, a game-time decision tonight. If he does not go, it's going to be interesting to see Bino. I don't even know how you say his last name. He's the...
It's like Udrit.
Udrit?
Udrit.
Okay. Udrit. he is looking to get the start. TTO, are you a Knicks fan at all?
No, I'm a Nets fan.
You're a Nets fan?
I was at the game last night. A miserable performance by the Nets.
So you're basically, do you think what do you think tonight has in store if Felton is not playing? Do you think Udrey is a guy that you might want to roster?
I mean, you might have to. I don't see how Paolo Prigioni can cover Brandon Jennings. It's just, he's old and slow, so I mean they have to start Udrih and just hope he can contain him a little bit. Otherwise, they're gonna put Shumpert on Brandon Jennings, and then it's just gonna mess the whole thing up. Because then you can't play JR and Shumpert. If Shumpert has to play defense on Brandon Jennings, then JR is just not gonna play. They can't put Melo at the four tonight because he's just gonna get killed by Drummond or Monroe. So I don't know. I just stay away from that game, to be honest. I mean, you could play Udrih just because he's minimum salary and hope, but otherwise I'd stay away from JR, I'd stay away from Melo. You just don't know what they're going to try tonight.
Yeah, I mean, that's obviously the thing as far as when you're not sure about where the minutes are going to go. Last night, or yesterday, I was talking about Jermaine O'Neal's absence and wasn't sure what that meant as far as the rotation goes. And it turns out that David Lee and Bynum, or sorry, not Bynum.
Oh, God. No Bynum on the Warriors,
yes,
please.
No. We will keep him there with the Cavs. Bogut, they both got extended minutes and both had a really good first half. Obviously, the game got out of hand in the second half. But another instance last night is the whole Dwan Blair incident. 50% of the FCK challenge on DraftKings were on Blair. A lot of people were on Blair on FanDuel, and they come out right before lineups lock and say that Dylan Bear's not even starting. They're going small with Crowder, and so you just don't know. You try to figure out what those rotations
are. Blair never starts. Blair never starts.
I mean, I wouldn't play Blair. I understand he's doing good, but you're paying for, even if it's minimum salary, for a guy that's going to play 20 minutes. So if he doesn't get these lucky putbacks, lucky open shots, he's not going to have a good game. I mean, it's such a risk to play a guy like that.
Yeah, the thing with Blair is that he was on the bench to begin with, and then when you bring in like Dylan Bear from the bench, you worry about minutes. He did get in foul trouble, but when Dylan Bear was playing good, they didn't go back to Blair, and so I think that it's going to be interesting to see if anybody goes back to the Blair train, because he...
I'll go for 30 tonight now.
He burned a lot of people. Colin says that he had 4 fouls in 7 minutes.
That's how much you play, yeah.
That is not good.
That's a solid night. That's
not good at all, especially when people were high on him. Let's talk about, though, FanDuel tonight. Who are you guys liking at the small forward position? Is Bron a guy that you need to play?
Go ahead. I was just saying, there's not too many, like, mid-price. I mean, you got to play Udra and, like, another cheapie to fit him. I think SF, you can go pretty cheap, like Martell Webster. There's a couple of really cheap guys there.
TTO?
I'm not really familiar with FanDuel salaries, but I agree. I mean, LeBron, I don't know how high he is, but he's probably going to be the highest score on the night. Yeah. So if you could afford him, you play him, but otherwise you got to go cheaper. Take a Martell Webster. Take a Josh Smith against Carmelo. Carmelo can't play defense on him. I mean, I don't know. Honestly, I just don't know the pricing. Yeah.
You have the pricing is pretty high for LeBron. You got LeBron or Kevin Love tonight. If all things are equal, where would you go, Nap?
Oh, man. I mean, they're both – I think Love's probably a little safer. I don't know why. I always go Love. I like getting the rebounds and just – I think LeBron's going to be too highly owned. They're both equal to me. They're both going to be 60% owned. It's just it's preference. there's no double-double bonus, so there's no edge there. So I don't know.
If all is equal, who would you take to take over?
I'd probably take LeBron every single time. I mean, he's just a superstar. I love playing out of his mind right now, but LeBron against Gustavo Ayon, I mean...
That's true.
Who's going to play defense on DeMar Carroll? If he want any time LeBron wants to play, he can go for 35. It's just a matter of if it's a blowout. I mean, it's hard to tell with a guy like that.
Yeah.
Wade's probably going to rest a little bit on back to back, or he's playing tomorrow too. So I don't know.
That's an interesting point with Wade. Do you think he goes? I think that if he didn't have a game tomorrow. In my first original roster on FanDuel, I actually had him in the lineup. I am a little worried that he is going to rest. On that Hawks side, though, you've got, for people that missed it, Paul Millsap is going to be out. Lou Williams also going to be out. He'll be playing tomorrow against the Pistons. But you've got both those guys that are out, and so you have Gustavo Ayon, who Dink compared him to Gustavo Fring from Breaking Bad. Pollo Hermanos? I think that was the restaurant. They'll have to confirm there in the chat. But I don't have a problem with rostering Gustavo tonight for value plays. Would you agree with that, Nap?
Yeah, I mean, probably going to get 30 minutes. It's Tim Horford and like Mike Scott. I mean, is there any other bigs there?
Horford, Scott, Ion, and not really. I can't. There might be some. There's always. It seems like there's always some like European backup player who I don't know. That's like the third string big man. So I can't think of it right now though.
Theoretically, you could put. He might not even play a lot because if LeBron's at the four, you could just go small and play Martin, Carroll, and Korver. I mean, Ion may only get 20 to 25 minutes at most. I mean, it's not like Miami's going to be throwing a bunch of big guys out there, and whoever they throw out there, Horford, it's going to go inside to Horford every time. So, I mean, for minimum salary, again, you can't go wrong with any minimum salary guy that's going to get minutes. It's tough to predict who's going to do what. Unless it's a point guard that you know they're going to get points. Guys like Ion, guys like Blair. Whenever you get a spot star from a four, you don't know. You just have no idea. Oh, and just one thing on Wade. The chances he plays tomorrow are so slim after them having to sit him in the second of a back-to-back. So I think he's just going to go all out tonight and get his 36 minutes, whatever he's going to play, and that's it. He's no chance he plays tomorrow.
Do you think he's going to get 7 or 8 steals tonight?
Nah, no way.
He absolutely went off the other night. Pulling up Gustavo Ayón's minutes, basically the last two games against the Sixers, he had 17 minutes, and against the Knicks, he had 20 minutes. So you have to think that his minutes will be a little bit higher with this, just because he'll be playing that power forward spot, and he'll also be getting some minutes probably at the backup center spot for Horford. So I think he'll have at least 25 minutes, and against the Knicks, he put up 10 points, 5 rebounds, an assist, a block, and 2 steals. So you'll see. Yes, I'm sorry. He's starting at the center. And Grant was actually talking about him yesterday. And Grant is a big Ayón lover. So he loves the Ayón. And so with him starting at center, Horford will be the power forward. Horford's a
guy. That doesn't mean anything.
Right, I mean, bigs are bigs. Something on
Horford's
fans,
not guarding LeBron.
Right.
Horford's still not going to guard LeBron. If he's the 3, the 4, or the 5, he's not going to be playing LeBron. It's still going to put Ayón on LeBron. You can't risk Horford getting cheap fouls on LeBron when he's your best offensive weapon against that team.
Horford is a guy I think you have to roster, though, tonight. He's going to get his minutes, and for me, with only 5 games, he's a very important piece of my lineups tonight. Agree or disagree, Knapp?
I agree. I mean, I'm looking at DraftKings right now. He's still under 9K. You can drop a little bit, so there's not much under him I'm like in love with. So yeah, I think Horford's almost a must play.
I mean, the problem with Horford is he hasn't went over 35 minutes yet. So they're just not giving him the minutes, no matter what the game is. Blowout, close game, the most he's playing is 35 minutes a night.
No Millsap, though. They have to ride him.
Yeah, but didn't Millsap not play a game this year? Or when he came off the bench, I don't know. I just don't understand what the point of the way they're running the team this year. Because wasn't he playing big minutes last year, Horford?
Yeah, I mean, I think that the Millsap thing, he came back pretty quick when he didn't start. I will pull up, though.
That was the Philly game,
I think, right?
Yeah,
it was the Philly game. But you're right. You look at the last game, and he played 30 minutes. And granted, they won by 20 over the Knicks, but he was frustrating. I rostered him in the FCK challenge that night, and he cost me dearly. So Horford is a guy that I think tonight I'm going to give him another chance, and hopefully he gets 35 minutes. Hopefully, I mean, you have to think that he's going to be the focal point with Millsap out. There's going to be lots of shots to go around without Millsap. So we'll see an extra 10 shots kind of distributed at least. And I think Horford is in line for 15 to 17 shots. So we'll see. We'll see what he can do. I'm in on Horford tonight. Let's talk, though, about some of the other games or other positions. Who are you guys liking at the point guard position, Knapp?
Let me bring that up really quick. Come on, oh my God, this is so slow.
I'll start with you to take over.
All right. Go ahead. I got
okay.
It. Go take.
That's Brandon Jennings.
Yeah.
He just has that, you know, don't want to say the words on a webcast, but he's got it in him that he's got that mentality. He's going to go off. He's going to take 25, 30 shots. And if he's on, he's going to score 40 points tonight. He'll get a few assists because I don't see Bargnani and Kenny Martin defending Drummond and Monroe. So, I mean, he has to. I don't see any way of the Knicks stopping Brandon Jennings tonight.
Okay, so you're high on Jennings, and that is certainly understandable. What about you, Knapp?
Yeah, right now Jennings Lynn is kind of the combo I'm looking at for FanDuel. Lynn's still, you know, I think he's 63, and I mean, he's been over 30 the last few games. So I mean, he's going to be on probably Avery, though. That's kind of scary. So it's either him or Isaiah for the second point guard for me right now, or Udra. I'm still thinking about him.
Yeah, I mean, he's definitely a cheap option if you want to get some players in there. For salary relief. There's also another guy, Patrick Beverly. Are you guys wasting your time on him? He's a boomer bust guy for sure. I think.
Yeah, I don't like him.
As long as Lynn's hot, he's not going to get the minutes.
I think he might be a boomer bust play tonight because his salary is still pretty down across the industry. So, I mean, he could get 20 to 25 points tonight.
I like him when Harden's out. Harden just kills people's shots and he just hogs the ball. I don't like it.
Yeah, and plus you have Howard tonight against a team that can't defend them. So, but the same thing was when he played the Knicks. They couldn't defend them, and I guess he can't score on Bargnani anymore. So.
Okay. Would you guys rather have Dwight Howard or Al Horford?
Man. Horford.
Horford's cheaper, and I just can't.
Free throws.
Unless you can tell me Boston's going to hack a Dwight, then I'll play Dwight. But otherwise, even the last game that he had, 25 free throw attempts just because they were hacking him at the end of a game.
I think we'll see. It'll be interesting to see if people still employ that strategy because you have one point per possession if he can make those. And that's what Morley, the GM, came out and said for the Rockets. So they want people to do that. We'll
see. Yeah, I don't understand. I've always thought about this. It makes no sense to hack a player. The worst guy's going to shoot 50%. And if you give a 50% field goal percentage in a game, you're going to lose. So you're giving the guy one out of 2 points every single time. You can't win a game or come back like that. It makes no sense to hack a player.
Yeah.
I mean, he's going to miss two a lot of the time. It depends how much you're down, I think. Like, if you're down, 3 points with 2 minutes left, I mean, I'd rather have Dwight shooting free throws than Harden shooting, anything.
Well, yeah. I mean, let's just go ahead and get to this rapid.
It's interesting game theory, though, from a coach standpoint, though. It's weird.
Let's get to this pick five real quick, because I want to see your guys' reaction, because some of these guys are in there. Another guy that Grant mentioned is Goran Dragic. He's a guy that 6,600 on FanDuel, pretty cheap elsewhere. I think he's certainly in play. If you want a cheap guy, you could do worse. I will say that. So let's look at this pick five. You have Carmelo Anthony or Dwight Howard?
Melo.
Yeah, you gotta go Melo.
All right. Corey Brewer or Damari Carroll?
I go Brewer.
Yeah. I think Carroll's, that last game, he was just draining everything. So I think he's going to come back down to earth. I like Brewer.
Oh, man, this is a tough one. If I had to pick, I would probably go, I'll probably go Brewer against Washington.
I mean,
he's going to get lots of minutes, too.
For that price, why not go Terrence Jones if you're going that cheap?
Yeah. Andre Drummond or Dwayne Wade?
I think you have to go Wade just because he's going to have the ball in his hands. He's been scoring. Drummond needs a lot of putbacks, a lot of rebounds. It's tough. It is tough.
Nap?
Man, I like Drummond. I don't think Barks is going to do anything. Kenyon Martin's like, Drummond, I can see, 20-20 tonight. Wade, that knee just scares me. I don't know what they're going to do, how they're going to rest him if they go up big. I think New York-Detroit's going to be a little closer, I think.
Well, the thing about Wade is, unless they're up 20 to 25 points, he always starts the fourth quarter. So you're guaranteed 3 minutes into the fourth. So, he's kind of close to blowout-proof, unless it's a real blowout.
I'm more worried about the knee issue, but I think Dwayne Wade is where I'll be leaning also tonight. Like I said, he's in my original lineups. Isaiah Thomas or Martell Webster? Martell Webster, a guy with Ariza being out, a lot of people are going to look at tonight for value. Going up against Isaiah Thomas against Phoenix, what are you guys thinking?
I go Webster just because he's a starter and it's close, so give me the minutes.
And I know people don't like psychological, but, he was on Minnesota, so revenge factor.
There you go.
Hey, we've seen the revenge factor play in, so I don't mind that at all. I'm also on Webster. I think it's a lot of minutes, and he is one of the top value plays tonight. Markieff Morris versus Nene.
To me, it's the same thing. I take Nene for the minutes.
me too.
Yeah, I actually like Nene, and I think that he's definitely in play even outside of the pick five. I think that especially on Fanduel, when I was looking earlier, his price tag is $5,500. So
I think he's exactly the same price on DK and Fanduel. So I mean,
The only thing I worry about is his rebound might be down, because when you got to cover Love, that when he's taking jump shots, you're not close to the rim, so rebounds just go down a little bit. I mean, maybe he loses two or three rebounds.
The thing with Nene is he can be so frustrating. I've taken him a lot over the past year and a half. Last year, it seems like I was always trying to take him on Draft Street. He just kind of disappears for times, and I'm not sure if it's like an effort issue or what, but he gets his points like in bulk, and then he'll just disappear for a few minutes. But I definitely like him over Markieff Morris tonight. So I think that's a good one. As far as that pick five, I don't know. I feel like if you want to do just the, I think the getting all five correct is going to be tough. But that first one is difficult for me. Carmelo versus Dwight. I'm not sold on Carmelo completely, and we'll see if Dwight kind of picks it up against Boston at home.
Let me ask you this: if the starting lineup is Udra, Shumpert, Melo, Bargnani, Kenny Martin, where are they scoring their points from tonight?
J.R. Smith.
Well, bench only. I mean, he's got to score tonight.
Yeah, I mean, he's got, and on a site like FanDuel, I mean, on a site like Draft Day, where you get a bonus point for three-pointers, I mean, I get it. It's just they also take points away for shots missed. And
but missed throws, too.
Well, I understand that as well. But he's capable of missing 15 shots tonight. How many shots did he have the other night? Like 30? Did he put up like 30 shots? Or like 29? It was upper 20s, I want to say.
Yeah,
it was ridiculous, but we'll see. Someone asked a question: if Wall is out, Bill gets a boost. The answer to that would be yes. Is Wall going to be out though? I haven't seen any news on this.
I don't think so.
No, I think he's fine. He just has a bad back.
Yeah,
but he's been okay recently. I mean, he's getting the painkillers, and I don't think I probably will stay away from him. But if you don't have him, it's fine.
Yeah. J.R. Smith went 3-for-18 last game.
Yeah, Melo went 17-for-30 against the Rockets.
He did have 30 shots. Man, that is rough. So they're saying that he's a game time decision. I just haven't seen that. We'll have to confirm that.
If Wall's out, you just go Beal and Webster across the board, I think. Like,
who's the backup point guard if Wall's out?
Is it Temple?
Oh, no, they have Maynard, no? Maynard's a good player if Wall's ever out.
Yeah. I mean, we saw him with the Thunder. Yeah, Maynard's the backup, and then Temple is the third string. So Maynard might be one of those sneaky plays, and one of those guys, if obviously it's not going to come out till the
3 hours,
till the first. So Roto Hobo says, how come Dave gets the big screen here? I get the whole screen now. How do you like it? It's because I have the controls. But yeah, that would be a good matchup for Ricky Rubio. Also, Rubio is a guy who I'm not going to have tonight, but I can see people rostering him in a GPP. Your thoughts on Rubio?
I was looking at just prop bets. Ricky Rubio points and assists tonight is only 18.5
totals.
Yeah, so points and assists. That's pretty awful.
That is very low.
It's miserable. I mean,
I think he's got like 9-9-5. That's their line tonight.
Yeah, basically it's what they're projecting. If he doesn't get you that double-double, it's killer.
So so basically, this Davis posted, and we don't see where Wall is going to be out, but who knows? That could be something that you want to check the Twitterverse for, to see where they go with it. I'm looking at the over-unders for these games. Basically, your high-scoring game tonight... let me pull this up. My computer froze on me.
There's three that are pretty similar.
Yes.
Phoenix Sac.
Let me see.
You think over-unders matter in NBA?
I take them into account.
So you wouldn't play guys from a low over-under?
It's not that I don't play them. It's that I want to play, especially if I have two players from the same game, two or three players, I will factor in the over-under as far as the number of points and the spread sometimes. So you had a low over-under last night in that Chicago game, and I should have not played Derrick Rose in all of my Draft Street lineups. I'm done with Derrick Rose. I'm done with him for the rest of the year until he gets in the middle of a hot streak. Not even the first game back. I want him to have three or four solid games and his price to be up for me to be able to take him, because I just will not continue to take the bait. Last night was the last straw for me.
I really don't like any Bulls this year so far.
To me, the problem with Rose is they don't have a three-point shooter for him. They really miss Kyle Korver.
Mm-hmm. Well, and you also have...
they got Dunleavy.
And you have Heinrich, who is handling the ball more. And so Derrick Rose doesn't even have the ball in his hands as much as you want him to. So we'll see. The over-under for tonight's game, the highest one... They don't even have it updated.
Want me to get it?
Yes, please get it. Please.
I mean, they're all I think mini wash, New York, Detroit, and Phoenix Sac are all over 200. So that, I mean, just if they're over 200, I think they're about, I consider them the same.
So when do you play Cousins and when do you not play Cousins?
So Cousins, Cousins is a guy who I would just rather have Horford or Howard in my lineup than Cousins tonight. Cousins is just so boom or bust.
It's great. It's either 52 or 26.
Yeah, pretty much. Do you like him tonight, though?
That's a great matchup.
So you're saying you do like him.
I like Cousins every night.
Sorry, the line's moved. Phoenix Sac dropped under 200. Boston, Houston's over 200. But Houston's favored by 10, so it's interesting.
Yeah, let's see. We have Minnesota, Washington at 205, and so basically, they're predicting Minnesota to win by four. That's what the spread is. Atlanta, Miami is 204.5 with a 9.5 point spread, and then Houston, Boston 205.5. So the high scoring team that Vegas is predicting is Houston tonight. That Phoenix-Sacramento game is interesting. I would have thought that there would be more points in that. I guess when you don't have anybody that can score, it's gonna be interesting. 194 with a 2-point spread for Sacramento. So
it's a Cousins night.
Well,
yeah.
I liked Bledsoe at the shooting guard position tonight, and we talked about Dragic earlier. Both those guys I liked against Sacramento. I'm not sure if this is really going to sway me from that, but thoughts on Bledsoe tonight?
When I was looking through it this morning, I was thinking about going Bledsoe Dragic, but then when you look at their box scores, they rarely both do well together, and I don't know what's going on there, but Dragic has been so bad, and then he has a good game. Bledsoe just takes a back seat. They strike me as a team that should be running up and down the floor, but they just don't do it. So, I mean, if you're going to play, just take Dragic. He's cheaper, and pay for someone else around Bledsoe's price.
Nap?
I like Bledsoe. I mean, shooting guards, there's only about four guys I'm considering. Bledsoe, Wade, Martin, or Beal. It just depends where you're going to spend money. I mean, if you go Beal-Martin, I think I kind of like that combo tonight. I think that's going to be a high-scoring, fast-paced game. Bledsoe's just, I mean, he needs steals. That over-under's kind of, I don't know why, it just dropped like 10 points since last night. I don't know. I mean, just depends what else you're thinking. You can fit Bledsoe, I don't have a problem with that at all. I like him over Dragic, for sure.
Yeah.
Over who?
Dragic. I just don't like Dragic.
Yeah, I mean, I like Bledsoe definitely at that shooting guard spot. So he's a high-energy guy. Those guys are always fun, especially to watch tonight, or to watch when they're on your team. You like to watch it. And
it's the late game, so you get a little sweat.
Yes, and you're coming back from that, so it'll definitely be interesting. Let's talk about the Houston game. Terrence Jones, do you still like him, even though Omer, how do you even say his name? I forget from last year. I feel like it's not...
It's ass cheek.
There you go.
I feel like it's a chic. There's some way saying it that I always messed up on last
Ashik.
Year.
Ashik.
Ah, chic. Thank you, Dink. Do you like Terrence Jones with Ashik presumably going to play tonight?
I do. I don't. I think if Ashik actually plays, he's just going to back up Howard for 12 to 15 minutes. I don't think he's going to play for Jones. Not against Boston. Boston has no big men that you would need both Howard and him on the floor.
Nap.
Yeah, he's 4.4 and 3.6. I mean, you're gonna get at least 27 minutes. I mean, he shoots threes, he steals. I mean, there's just the upside's there. I love that price. You can't fade that.
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing. It's his price, and as the takeover said, you've got a Sheik who is now backing up Dwight. So they tried. Obviously, Ashik didn't want to take the back seat. So when they brought on Dwight, they tried to do the Twin Towers thing, and it did not work at all. So then they wanted to bring Ashik off the bench. And so that you've got Terrence Jones, and where his salary is, it's going to be hard to fade him on those sites that have a minimum salary, because he is going...
And then Vegas thinks Houston's going to score the most, so, I mean... Why not?
Yeah, why not? I mean, that's the thing. Why not? And what about pairing him? One thing that I like to do on some of the sites are pair big men together. Like pairing Ion and Horford together. Last night I paired Bogut and Lee together. Tonight, dare I say, Dwight Howard and Terrence Jones together. The takeover, you're rolling your eyes on me.
I just, it's funny because you almost have to play Gustavo Ayon today, but it's just such a miserable play because he's Gustavo Ayon. But you almost don't have a choice at minimum salary. But then at the end of the night, you're going to go, I can't believe I lost because I had Gustavo Ayon.
Just funny saying that name. Just like, you're playing Gustavo Ayon for money.
What do you think, what do you think his stat line is? You think it's like 12-6?
Gustavo? Yeah. He's probably, the way I'm talking, he's probably 25-13.
I'll say 14-8 with one block and one steal.
Makes sense.
It's so funny that the takeover is talking so bad about him, because I know you're going to have him in your lineups tonight. It's just you don't want to have him in your lineups. So who do you like more? Condia or Gustavo Ayon?
What nationality is Condia?
Oh my gosh.
He's American.
Gonna go Condia then.
Oh gosh. Oh, you don't like Condia at all. Are you still picking up his games?
I play him once in a while. I mean, his lineups, they're just weird. Some of the picks he makes make no sense. They work out for him, but does anybody think they're going to keep working out for him? If every night somebody's looking at his lineups and going, why do you take that player? Why do you take this guy? Eventually it should even out.
Do you think he's doing something different, Knapp? Do you think he's doing something different this year? It seems like for NBA, he's doing a lot better than he was last year.
I think he's starting to play two lineups tonight, right? Like, he doesn't play just one lineup. Like, take a few of his games. I think you'll see he's starting to hedge a little bit. But yeah, from what I've seen, he just one night he had Paul Pierce on, like, when he was like a game time decision. It's just weird stuff.
It's just working out. I mean, he's not Mr. Wonderful, that's for sure.
Yeah, G123 the Beast.
Who is, though? Condia is, he's the most successful person this season, by far, in the NBA. Mm-hmm. I mean, he is at top of everything, and he's putting in a lot of volume. So I'm interested to see how long it can continue, but he is head and shoulders the hottest player. And like you said, sometimes his picks don't make a ton of sense, but they work for him. And even last night, he was like one of the top scorers on FanDuel, top scorer on DraftKings.
He must have faded someone that did bad last night. He's been fading a lot of players. Like, he just fades. I think, I don't know if he does it on purpose or whoever's giving him stats is giving him something different. But I think he's fading a lot of these guys that were all on. He's not on them. Like, I think Saturday night, he took, let me pull it up.
Yeah, he is, and that is one thing that the fades are almost better than being on the hot players this year, because there are a lot of landmines. I think even on, like, Draft Street, the scores have been considerably down from last season on Draft Street. And it's because a lot of guys are just landmines. And if you avoid those, you're good. Do you have that game pulled up?
Yeah, so Saturday night, he first of all, he didn't play Tony Rolton. Wow. And he played CJ Miles off that miserable game that he had. The rest of his team, Miles had 11.75 that night. I mean, he
slept.
Yeah, he put up 269.25. He had a good team. His teams are good. It's just some of the players make no sense. Like, why would you not play Tony Rolton? The guy's was 4,200.
When he plays that many head-to-heads, I think he doesn't want overlap. I think he really likes getting an edge over just having different players, no matter what they do. I don't know. It just has to be some reasoning about not wanting an obvious play just based on his volume. I don't know.
Yeah, especially a guy that's coming off a triple-double. I mean, obviously he's not going to get 51, but New Orleans is a good enough matchup that you play a guy for 4,200.
So here is my matchup with him last night. You can see that he went Boozer, and he went Reggie Evans, and he
can't see that.
He did that on a few sites. So his lineup: Roten, Livingston, Marion, Evans, Boozer, Calderon, Durant, and Westbrook.
Wow.
So he went Durant and Westbrook, and that's really
that was last night.
That's really what helped him. But he faded.
Blatch.
Yeah, he faded Ibaka. Blatch and Ibaka and Blair. And he went with Evans. And he went with Evans on another site, too. So,
what did Evans have, like six?
Yeah, Evans had 9 rebounds, 5 points. So not too bad for minimum salary there.
Yeah, but all he did, he got the news late that Evans was starting, and he just plugged him in. That's really all he did. I mean, Evans was a better play than DeJuan Blair last night, but they were both minimum salary, and Evans was starting. So. Yeah,
and we have Tuttle, who posted his game with him as well. So it's just, I mean, and that was a pretty big score, but he's been on top of it. So it'd be interesting to see if he can continue.
You can't argue that he's the best right now. I mean, his scores are unbelievable. It doesn't make sense. And NBA is just one of those sports that if it doesn't make sense long enough, you're not going to keep winning. And MLB, nothing G123 does makes any sense. But you know that it's going to win. You just know. Once you see his lineup, you go, why do you play that guy? Oh, Chase Elliott, 4 home runs off a lefty. That makes sense.
Well, and you say in the Lou Dogs forum, I was talking about this earlier, you have people who say, you know, all you need is a good model. But there is a human element to it. Even with G123, you have, you know, you had the matchup with Hicksville Hunk, where Hicksville Hunk actually beat him in that head-to-head on Draft Street. So there is a human element to it, but obviously there is something that Condia is doing different this year and for NBA. Last year, he was out of it pretty quick. Some people said that one Ucror or whatever the other guy that he was bankrolling. But there is definitely a method to his madness this year. And like I said, I'm just interested to see if it can continue. We'll see. But anyways.
I mean, with the amount of money he's playing, the amount of money he has compared to everyone else, he can lose for 10 days in a row and then win two in a row, and everybody will still think he's doing great. That's not happening right now, but he just has so much more bankroll than anyone else going right now. So we'll never know how he's really even doing.
Yeah, but just from experience this season, he might have had one or two losing days, maybe.
Yeah.
And the rest has just been,
hot.
Crushing it. So
he must have won probably close to 30, 40 NBA seats already for the 1,500 on DraftKings. He wins every single qualifier, it seems like.
On DraftKings?
Yeah. He's going to be close to... he wins all the NFL ones, too, so he's going to end up being close to, like 60, 70 seats for that, I think. I mean, I could be way off, but it just seems like he's winning a qualifier a day.
Oh, man, he's going to be napping that thing for sure. He's Al says he's been the top 5% lineup across the industry 10 of the past 12 nights, and I agree. I mean, he's been he's been absolutely ridiculous. Just to kind of recap the games and the news, we have Martell Webster, who's going to be a decent value play tonight, filling in for Trevor Ariza. You have basically Raymond Felton, who's a game-time decision. If he doesn't go, a guy named Bino is who you might want to consider. Paul Millsap going to be out for the Hawks, as well as Lou Williams. And so you are going to get more run out of Gustavo Ione, who is the TakeOver's favorite player. So he's going to be an interesting value play. And we'll see if Damari Carroll, you know, he's going to be a high energy guy. I'm interested to see if anyone is going to be rostering him tonight. Nap, what are your thoughts?
I'm not touching Damari. I mean, I used him a little bit earlier, and just that. I mean, people are going to be on him because his last game. I just think it's a good fit. I don't know why. I'd rather have Terrence and Webster if you're going cheap small forward.
Well, Carroll's last game wasn't that good. It was two nights ago that he was
on fire. Yeah,
that was the night that Condia played Carroll over all the good cheap guys too, and he went for 36 or whatever it was. I mean, how do you just can't predict it at this point.
I played Carroll that night too.
I think that was the night that everyone had C.J. Miles and he had Carroll. So then the next night he takes C.J. Miles. Law of averages, I guess, with him. I don't know. And he had James Anderson the night James Anderson went for 52.
Yeah, that was crazy.
That was the game that went into overtime where no one could miss. And he had stocked up on those guys. Yeah, I mean, the legend of Condia, again, we'll see where it kind of takes of them, where it takes them. So as far as tonight, give me your must play that you have to have in your lineup, TTO.
I want to say Brandon Jennings.
You're all about Brandon Jennings.
But now if I don't play Brandon Jennings, I'm going to look like I was trying to get everyone else to play Brandon Jennings. But I just, he's my kind of player.
Nap?
Must play tonight. Oh, man. I was leaning Jennings, too. Point guard. There's not much going on at point guard tonight. I'll say Horford, just based on minutes, no Millsap. I think Horford's going to just bonkers.
You think he's going to bonkers?
I mean, especially DraftKings 8,600. I mean, I can't see a fade there.
What about Bargnani tonight?
Maybe.
Been getting 30-plus every game.
I know, and he's going to have – it depends on if Felton's out. But he's
– And he did fine versus Howard, so –
He's certainly an interesting play. I will go with my must play since you took Horford. I will go with Dwight Howard. I think he's going to have a beastly night tonight. So, no, change that. Looking at the rosters, Cousins is cheaper than Dwight Howard is, so I'm going to make him my must play. I'm going to make Cousins my must play.
He's always at least half as much owned, too, so I mean, I like that.
So I should have Cousins, Horford, and Brandon Jennings tonight. Can't lose.
Yes. On some sites, you can't have that, but yeah, on that's a good GPP core. It would scare me to play all three of those in a cash game. especially not Horford. Well, yeah, even Horford, because Horford burned me last game. But that's a
wait till Condia has all three tonight. There you go.
Those guys definitely have the high upside for sure. Let's take a look at the Star Street pick five and get your guys' thoughts on it. Carmelo Anthony or James Harden?
I'm going Melo.
Yeah, I go Melo too. Closer game.
Cousins or Horford?
Cousins.
I'll say Horford, less chance of ejection.
I'll go Cousins for upside, but Horford is a guy... That's a decent matchup. Peter did a good job with that matchup. Jeff Teague versus Bledsoe.
Bledsoe.
I'll go Bledsoe as well.
I'll go Teague because I've hated him, but he's been great. And Miami doesn't play point guards that well, I don't think. I don't know.
Jace. What's that? Knapp, what'd you say?
I was saying, Chalmers, I consider solid defender. Teague just my kryptonite. If I play him, it's not going to work.
Josh Smith or Dwayne Wade?
Josh Smith, Dwayne Wade. Jake, what do you think? That's close.
Yeah, that's a pretty good one. I'd probably lean towards Wade just because Josh Smith hasn't been that great. I mean, it's so hard for him to get rebounds on that team. So it's hard for him to put together a complete game.
I'll say Wade too. Yeah, Smith is another guy. It's just 50 or 20.
Dragic or Rubio?
God.
I feel like that one's set up. I feel like that one's set up as a trick. That Peter did that so everybody would get on Rubio. You take a look at the points per game, and Rubio is almost double the points per game of Dragic. But I like Goran Dragic tonight, so I think I will be playing. I don't know. I've got a lot of the Suns Kings exposure in that with Cousins, Bledsoe, and Dragic. So if that's a low scoring game like Vegas has said it's going to be, might be in trouble there.
My gut says Rubio there. It's just...
Who comes into the games for Plumlee?
For
Markieff.
For Plumlee, the Morris twins.
Yeah. So, once Plumlee's out of the game, it's Cousins versus the Morris twins?
Yes.
Pretty much.
I mean, he's set up to have that 52-point game.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, you're putting your reputation on it. So...
I told you, Cousins, Jennings, and Gustavo Ayala.
All right, guys. Well,
God, those are the...
I mean, it's going to be – tonight's an interesting night. It's a five-game night, so don't get too angry. That's what I tell people. Don't get too angry if your players don't do well because you deserve what you get if you play a lot on a five-game night, just like a four-game night. So be smart with your bankroll, but have fun with it, and that's what we're always going to try to do. Knapp, TakeOver, two of the best guys in the industry – appreciate you guys joining me today. It was fun, and
I just want to say one more thing. You also deserve what you get if you play Gustavo Ayon.
You think so?
Yeah. If you I stop when Maya comes on.
Oh well. You guys get what you deserve if you listen to these two guys, two of the best in the business. So appreciate you guys joining us. Tomorrow should be a good show, our Wednesday show. 3:30 Eastern is when we'll start. If you have any questions, feel free to ask us on Twitter, and we'll get to them. Right?
Maybe. How can you not like this song? Yeah.